Ain't this what they've been waiting for? You ready?
Morning, everybody. Today is Wednesday, February 1st. Happy first day of the month. Today is CV High School's signing day for some of our college athletes. That's happening at 2 p.m. today. Beforehand, we're going to have some pre-signing day interviews with a few of our athletes, and we're just going to see what CV High School signing day is all about.
Hey everybody, I'm here with senior Isaac Sines. He's attending Millersville to play football. Hello, Isaac.
Hello.
How was your experience visiting Millersville different from your visit at SHIP?
They were both very nice. Both campuses and coaches are awesome, but I feel like Millersville, their coaches really like tried to make a relationship with me, and that really set well with me.
How are you preparing for your position change from a high school QB to a college receiver?
Just watching like other receivers that, you know, I like their game, try to watch them, watch their film, and then, you know, going out and throwing the ball with my dad, my friends, whatever it may be, to try and be the best I can, and talking to the coaches and whatnot.
Awesome. Congrats.
Thank you.
Hey, everybody. I'm here with Marquise Williams. He's going to Minnesota to play football. How are you as a person and a player preparing to play at the Division I level?
Lately, I've just been locked in. Focus on the next level, and as a person, I'm just pretty chill. Like, lately I have matured. I ain't say I'm doing like crazy stuff, but like I'm mature and been a pretty chill person.
What experience did Minnesota give you that your other 30 D1 offers did not?
I was going to go on an official visit to Iowa, but when I went on Minnesota, it was basically how the coaches treated the people. Outside of football, they care a lot about the people and like a lot about people's mental health, and mental health is important. So like they do activities outside of football with the team, and the culture is pretty nice, and they run the ball. So
that's awesome. Yeah. All right. And then what what drew your attention the most to pick your college pick at Minnesota?
I'm not going to lie. I think it was Saturday, and we went to the head coach's lake house, and he took all of the recruits on a boat on a lake.
So that's awesome, really?
Yeah, so I was like, wow, this is nice. And it's like in the summer, it doesn't get humid.
Yeah.
It just it's hot. It doesn't get humid, so.
That's awesome. Cool. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Hey everybody, I'm here with Griffin Huffman. He's attending Westchester to play football. What impact did your brother playing at Westchester have on your decision?
I'd say it definitely was an impact because I've never got to play football with him yet on the team. So it's definitely a cool opportunity. He never really pushed it on me, but it definitely made an impact on choosing Westchester.
Other than possibly getting a chance to play at the next level with your brother, how was your experience at Westchester different from your other experiences at your other college options?
I'd say Westchester definitely has like the best of everything in school aspect, sports, and kind of like the city vibe. I kind of like that. The other choices, I would have mostly chose just for football and not anything else. So I definitely chose Westchester because it had everything. And I definitely know that relationship with more of a receiver coach than any other coach.
Congrats. Hey everybody, I'm here with Sam Perkin. She's attending IUP to play lacrosse.
Hello, Sam.
Hi.
What impacted your decision on picking IUP the most?
I just really like the team environment, and the school was really nice. I knew a couple of people that were already going there, so it just really made it feel awesome.
What are you most excited for about attending IUP?
I'm most excited about just playing at a higher level of lacrosse.
How did your experience visiting IUP differ from your experiences from your other colleges?
The coach was just very transparent with me, and she was a lot more open about my offer and everything than all the other coaches, and she expressed that she wanted me, and all of the other coaches were kind of just waiting on me, and she actually put it out there, so I kind of just grabbed onto it.
That's awesome. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Hey everybody, I'm here with Jenna Herbster. She's attending University of Massachusetts to play field hockey. You committed in early October of 2021. What about UMass made you know that that school was the one, and what impact did UMass have on you that other schools did not?
I knew UMass was the one because I love the culture of the school. It's a beautiful campus.
And after meeting the coaches and the team, I decided that was the right school for me.
What are you most excited for about attending and playing at UMass?
I'm excited to just play at the next level and have a brand new team and new best friends and to meet new people with like the internationals and stuff and to just live the college life.
Awesome. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Hey everybody, I'm here with Ashley Pines. She's going to be attending Penn State University for track and field. What about PSU drew your attention the most to make your college pick there?
I'd say Penn State track and field has amazing facilities. I really like the coach. He was always super talkative. And also the girls, they are very welcoming.
What is the most exciting part about committing to Penn State?
I just would say overall, like, I feel like Penn State's so well known. Anyone I tell that I'm going to Penn State, they're like, holy crap, you know? Yeah. So it's just a really big school. And I love that besides track, you know, fun football games, it's just a really fun atmosphere.
What motivates you the most to try and run faster whenever you get to college?
Trying to be my best version of myself and continuing to push myself to limits I didn't know necessarily I could always achieve.
Perfect. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Hey everybody, I'm here with Kira Crowley. She's going to Xavier to play lacrosse. How did you know you were D1 and when did you know you were able to keep up with the D1 aspect?
From middle school, I always had aspirations to play D1 lacrosse in college. So from there, I knew I had to be even more dedicated to make my dreams into reality.
Perfect. What are you most excited for about playing at Xavier?
I'm really excited to be one of the first classes to be there with the new program. I feel like we are so eager to prove ourselves and show the lacrosse world what we can do.
And what about Xavier made you want to go there more than your other D1 offers?
The atmosphere made Xavier so special. Everything from the coaches to the campus. I'm so excited to be there and see what else it has to offer.
Awesome. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Feeling like it's my time. My time. Yeah, it's no more waiting, yeah. Lights, camera, action, tell the whole world that I'm back and I'm activated, yeah. Yeah. Activated, yeah. Activated, yeah. Yeah. Feeling like it's my time. My time. Yeah, it's no more waiting, yeah.
Lights, camera, action, tell the whole world that I'm back and I'm activated, yeah. We'll be going to Westchester University. Our next athlete, football, Isaac Symes, will be going to Millersville University. Our next athlete, football, Marquise Williams, University of Minnesota.
In order now they always say congratulations. Work so hard, forgot how to vacation.
What's up, everybody? That's a wrap on CV High School's signing day. We got to hear from a few of our amazing athletes in some of our interviews today, which was amazing. We got to see them sign. I think it was about 33 athletes signing today, which is amazing, representing CV like we should. And thank you for coming along. Bye.